Hey foodies, welcome to Cooking Shooking. If we do something like a requested recipe of the year, then it would be jalebi for 2014. We have received a ton of requests for it. I've been experimenting all year to make the perfect jalebi that is crispy from out, filled with syrup inside and juicy, and does not get soggy at all. And of course, is better than the market ones. So I'm going to speak a little more about it. If you wish to skip to the recipe itself, click my face to do so. In the last day, I have tried almost every way to make a jalebi, be it the traditional way using some yogurt and keeping for 24 hours, with curd and baking soda, with only baking soda, even with a portion of urad dal and plain as well, but no luck. And then the instant way is using baking soda and baking powder, using yeast, using eno, using baking soda and citric acid, using a little bit of urad dal as well, but again no luck. Right from jalebis turning soggy, jalebis that are bread-like, jalebis that are chewy, jalebis that do not take the syrup in, and jalebis that are crunchy like hell as well. After numerous attempts, here is my perfect recipe for you all, that is in fact much better than the market ones, because there is nothing like eating a piping hot jalebi straight from the pan. I believe there are two kinds of jalebis that the halwais make. One is a kulcha kind, that something like we make yogurt daily at home, and the other one is something like I'm going to show you today. It is very easy to make jalebis, just a little tricky, but I'll try to explain as much as possible, but I'll be more elaborate in the website cookingshooking.in. So let us start making the jalebis now. So we're going to start by making the syrup for this. So I'm going to take 2 cups of sugar in a saucepan, along with which I'm going to add in 3/4 cup of water. So now I'm going to heat this up. So this recipe doesn't require much fermentation or something like that. This is a kind of instant recipe. So that is the reason I have heated the sugar syrup at the first. So I'm going to just stir the sugar syrup. So we're going to wait for the sugar syrup to get a roaring boil. What I would suggest is do not add any flavorings until and unless you have got the perfect results. I myself don't add any flavorings because it tastes super heavenly as it is. By flavorings, I mean the rose water, cardamom and so on. So it looks like our sugar syrup has got a roaring boil. And by the color itself, you can judge that the sugar syrup is a little dirty. So I'm going to add in a little bit of milk to this. If your sugar syrup is dirty, then only add it, otherwise you can skip it. So just about 2 to 3 tablespoons of milk. Now I'm going to lower the flame a little bit so that all the dirt comes up and then we can skim it off. So let me just skim the dirt off. So our syrup is now clear, so now I'm going to add in color to this. Kesar food color, saffron food color. You can also add a little bit of saffron if you wish to, but I'm going to skip it. Now with the look itself, I can tell the syrup is ready for me. If you wish to test it, you can definitely test it. You do not want any thick threads. You just want a very thin syrup, but not watery thin. About 1 string consistency would be perfect. By the way, you can also use 50-50 of jaggery and sugar if you wish to. So let me switch off the flame and I'm going to just add in a little bit of cream of tartar. You can also add in lemon wedges if you wish to. Just like we make golden syrup, we add some lemon wedges, right? So just cut some lemon and add it inside and get it to a boil and then take the lemon wedges out. So I'm going to just sprinkle a little bit of cream of tartar. You can also squeeze in a little bit of lemon juice or a pinch of citric acid. So the syrup is all ready, so now let's make the batter for it. What makes this jalebi perfect is this hydro or rung cut. Just a pinch of it is valuable in this recipe. Very easily available in most grocery stores. I must say wholesale grocery stores and baking supply stores. I get this from a baking supply store. They're going to just add in a pinch of this and you'll see the magic. So let us start making the batter now. So I'm going to take about a third of a cup of water in this bowl. Water just so that the hydro mixes really well with it. So I'm going to just take a good pinch of this hydro. So now I'm going to add in 1 cup of plain flour maida to this. No whisk or spoons, I'm going to get my hands in and we're going to mix this and you will see what will happen next. We want a very stiff and very thick batter at the first. So the mixture is just a little dry, so I'm going to add in just about 1.5 to 2 tablespoons of water to this. Be very careful with the amounts of water. This can turn into a watery mess otherwise. It may look like thick at first, but it is going to go very flowy. So right now you can see this is a kind of a paste like this, but I'm going to just mix this really well and I'm going to kind of mix this or knead this, whatever you call it. Just get my hands in and get it rotating like this and mix this for about 5 minutes and you will see what will happen. This will turn from this mass to a flowing consistency. So for about 5 minutes, and you remember it was paste kind of thick. So see now. This is a little stiff than I want it to be, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to wet my hands and then I'm going to whip it for about 30 seconds. So just wet your hands and add it. I mean, just wet your hands and whip it for about 30 seconds. The consistency is a little difficult to explain, but have you ever seen a halwai making these? When he presses the batter, it flows out in a single string or it flows out slowly, and when he stops the pressure, it stops. So the consistency is like so, and the flowiness comes from this hydro as well. You can see now how flowy this is. So the batter is thick yet flowy. So it is all ready to make jalebis now, but we are going to add baking powder to this, about 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, and you will see a lot of aeration or air bubbles as well in this right now before adding the baking powder itself. So the batter is all ready. Let me mix the baking powder really well. So the batter is all ready, so let me fill a piping bag. You can also use a Ziploc bag or a ketchup bottle if you wish to, or you can get a stitch cloth for yourself. So to the piping bag, let me add the batter. I'm going to only add about half at first. So to make the jalebis, it is advisable to use a frying pan with about 1/2 inch of oil in it. I have made jalebis in oil and ghee both, but I prefer to make them in oil. The temperature is very crucial here. If your oil or ghee is very hot, you will not be able to make the shapes, and if it is cold, it is not going to be good. So let me make the jalebis now. I feel the oil is perfectly hot. What happens if your ghee or oil is hot is, when you pipe it a little bit, it will just move with it. I mean, the shape will just move with your hand then. So what I'm going to do is snip the bottom of this piping bag. Be careful, do not snip it too much because you cannot make it smaller then. And it is also your hand's pressure which makes the jalebis thicker or thinner, not only the diameter of the hole. Before shaping your jalebis, make sure your syrup is warm, neither hot nor cold. Along with that, make sure you have at least 1.5 to 2 inches of syrup in your pan or a bowl. Otherwise, you will be sugarcoating your jalebis and not making the syrup go inside the jalebis. As soon as we take out the jalebis from the hot oil, I'm going to just dunk them in and I'm going to press this like this so that it goes inside. So let me start making the jalebis now. So let's make jalebis. All you need to do is be patient and shape the jalebis and cook them in medium flame, and just cook them like this in medium flame until they get cooked really well and most of the bubbles are gone. Now you need to be very fast. As soon as you take them out from the pan, you need to dunk them in. So keep this handy, and the syrup should be warm. Take them in, dip them in, take them, dip them, take them, dip them. Because if you do not do this, what will happen is, let me show you. You take a jalebi, you take out all the oil, be very patient with it. Most of the times I have seen that many people do this. They take out all the oil, be patient with it, and then slowly, after all the oil is taken out, they will add them in. And they will just touch it like this in the syrup. So let me take out all the three jalebis that I added before, and let me show you what happened to the fourth one. So these were white and now they are golden. That's the magic. All the syrup is inside them. And the fourth one, let me show you very closely. If you can see, there are two jalebis. One is really even in the color and the syrup is really all around really well, and the other one is white at spots and there is syrup at spots. And if you delay it even more, what will happen is this jalebi will be white and it will be sugar coated and not sugar soaked. The syrup will not be there. It will be just that the sugar is coated outside the jalebi and there is no syrup inside. So that is going to happen. So as soon as you take out from the oil or ghee, dip them in inside and take a spoon or anything and just keep them inside. That's the reason behind you need to have at least 1.5 to 2 inches of syrup in your pan. So let me make more jalebis now. If your syrup cools down while you are making more jalebis, you can just reheat a little bit and make sure it is warm always. So the jalebis are cooked. Let me take them in to the syrup. These jalebis won't turn soggy when you keep them in the sugar syrup. You can literally feel the hardness and the crispiness of it when it is in the oil, and when you take them out from the syrup itself, you can literally feel they are crispy now and there is juice inside. Because there is nothing like eating a jalebi straight from the pan. Let me make more now. So our jalebis are all ready and they have been like this for about 15 minutes or so and they aren't soggy at all. Crispy on the out and filled with the sugar syrup inside, totally yummy, heavenly I must say. So make sure you visit cookingshooking.in and read all the steps in there as well. I have elaborated there really well as well. Thank you for watching. Just make them like I have shown you and you'll be proud of yourself. Do subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching. Bye. Take care.